What's going on, guys? This is Bossrosslp, and welcome back for the wide world of Skyrim. In the last episode, or should I say the last session, hello, music. You left me. No, I guess I just had to loop. That was a really awkward loop. Either way, of course I starve right when the loop happens. Either way, in the last fantastic episode, session, whatever the hell it was, of Skyrim, we got started on the Wheels of Lull, even though I did not know what it was at the point. That is basically what we got ourselves started on. In this episode, or session, I should say, I guess I'm kind of used to saying episode now that I'm doing plural. Guess it's time to get started on more of that. Though, generally, I kind of want to leave here, because I don't want to do it all at once. What type of beneficial potion, restore, fortify, do you want to specialize in? I guess health? Yeah, I had some new mods. Oh boy, Ordinator perk reset. This is going to be one of the first perks that you guys are going to be able to see that I selected. I selected the Ordinator perk reset. Now, the reason I selected this, the reason why I got this perk reset, is because it adds a shitload more perks to the game, and I think I'm gonna have to re-choose all my perks yet again because it reset like this, but we'll just see right now. Yeah. I have 28 perks to increase. Nope, it's still increasing. Still increasing. Now it's up to 40, and 50. 50 perks to increase. Holy shit. Let's get selecting. So first off, I think we better start with smithing because we already had smithing completely maxed out. Oh boy. What the fuck? Wait, what? Whoa, this is weird. Yeah, there's going to be a lot more perks now. It's going to be ridiculous. So it seems like a couple of these are still good. From the looks of things, anyway. Because I still got my one-handed... Oh, no, I don't, actually. Wow. This is a lot to look at. Targets at full health, this power does okay. A gladiator. Uh-huh. And wounds? Okay. Mangle. Power attacks with war axes do more stagger damage. Forward power attacks with the war axes. Oh my god, this is so much shit. I sort of want to do this all off screen, but at the same time, it's pretty interesting. This is war axe stuff. Yeah, I do have a war axe, right? Yeah, because this is one-handed. What the hell? Okay. Wait, what? Oh my god, that's a shitload of extra damage. Like, considering my stamina is 380, that's like triple damage. That's ridiculous. Either way, man, we have a lot to look at. I guess I should get started on alchemy. I don't even know where to begin anymore. What? What? Oh my god. This is fucking ridiculous, man. Look at all this. Look at it all. So many extra shit. So much extra shit. Alright, go for enchanting, I guess. Alright, I got that all done. How about this stuff? Small amount of experience when using a staff in combat. That's garbage. Ew. Ew. Ew, ew, ew. No scrolls. Sprinkle its dust on the arcane enchanter. New enchantments are 20% stronger when placed upon an item of the type corresponding to the gem. What? What? A flawless gem. When you begin the enchanting process and sprinkle its dust on the... That I can't even, like, comprehend what that even said. What? Sure. Let's grab it. Just in case. Learning items enchantment does not destroy it. That's not necessary. Okay. That's okay. Actually, you know what? I do have clothes. So, actually, that's not bad. Enchantments on items are 15% more powerful when equipped. Okay. That sounds pretty fantastic. Regenerate magicka faster when wielding a staff. That's weird. So I guess this has a lot to do with staves now, or staves, whatever. both weapons lose charge points at a rate of 20 points per second, but the enchantment on them are 25% more powerful or less. No? Oh my god, this is ridiculous. Huh? At will, drain 1/4 of your weapon charge to restore magic equal to 20% of your right charge. Stamina equal to 20. What? Can I just go for this? To the next item you enchant at the Arcane Nexus, placing up to 3 enchantments upon that are 50% stronger. Try as you might, you'll never be able to repeat this feat. What? So. Well, alright. Okay, I'm not even going to worry about that. I'm going to worry about smithing, I guess. Alright. Can smelt gold ingots into 250 gold. No. I already have that. Or, no, apparently I didn't have that. I guess I was lying. No, I already have this. So, it's glowing, but I was able to pick it again. That's really weird. Alright, whatever. Workbench to an advanced version. Items may be learned at... Okay. Uh-huh. Okay. That's pretty sweet. Okay, that's broken. All this shit is just ridiculous. You may choose to sacrifice a dragon soul to improve items by a further tier during that session. Alright. Items of the chosen type can be improved 20% better at a grindstone or workbench. I guess one-handed. If you specialize in an armor type, your attacks ignore 15% of the armor rating of an enemy. If you specialize in a weapon type, you take 10% less damage from weapons of the chosen type. Alright, sure, why not? Heart of Creation. You may choose to pour your dragonborn blood into the fire of one forge. If you do, whenever you create an item at that forge, you may choose to permanently increase your health, magic, or stamina by 1/2000th of its value with a minimum of 0.01 points. Okay. That sounds fun, I guess. That sounds a little annoying. Lock is better. Do I still have, like, I don't think they still have Block Runner. Cast aside. Do they have Unstoppable Force? Yes, they still have that, thank god. And it's only 90 now, oh my god. You take no damage on a successfully timed block. That's pretty broken. No? Huh. Last attackers disarmed violently and all within an 8-foot radius are staggered. I have no idea what a timing streak is. Okay. Poke the dragon. Yeah, I'm just gonna go for this stuff. I'm sorry this is taking a while, but this is just hilarious. I just can't even begin. You cannot perform the time block for 3 seconds. Okay. I want to get Block Runner. So, I do want Block Runner. Hold the line. During a timed block, allies within 10 feet gain 250 extra armor. Oh my god, that's broken. What the fuck is that? Deflect arrows. Yes. Okay, that's pretty sweet. Power Bash. I want a Power Bash. Bastion deals 3% more damage per point of stamina. Oh my god! That is unbelievably powerful blocking. Oh my god. Infuriates living targets for 60 seconds. They won't flee from combat, but cannot regenerate stamina and deal no damage on a time block. That's kind of hilarious. There you go. That sounds awesome. That's sort of like Unstoppable Force, but a little less broken. Because they have to power bash for that. I guess for one-handed, I better get started on my axe shit. That is daggers, dual wielding, I don't want to worry about war axes, so. I can't pick that for some reason. Oh, I have to get better one-handed mastery. Now I can pick that. Go good. Shield biter. Okay. Sure. I'm just picking all this stuff and see what happens. Okay. And that's pretty fantastic. So I basically just maxed out the axe for a little bit. Archer would be nice. Yes. Bashing with the bow stacks targets. That's not useful. Yes. I don't actually want slowed time. Move at full speed. Yeah, that's what I want. Definitely want that. Now, where's the one that, like, lets me charge faster? Is that also over here? It probably is. Weapon juggler. That's weird. Standing still for 6 seconds, it does 20 now. That's ridiculous. Shooting a staggered target within 10 feet is a critical strike and knocks a target down. That's pretty annoying. No. Where's the one where you shoot an arrow to the knee? That's kind of hilarious. Clean kill is nice. Wing strike. Now, where's the one that, like, lets you draw faster? Or would that be in, that's not Ranger. Hunter's Discipline was nice. That's pretty sweet. I guess it doesn't exist anymore. Alright, fair enough. Wait, what the? There's like a point up in the sky. This is really weird. I'm sorry I'm starting out the episode like this. Maybe I'll cut all this. I probably will. Hopefully I won't. Who knows? As a leaf. Yeah, the actually fun parts will be starting out. Don't worry, guys. Taking no hits for 10 seconds. I'm not even gonna worry about that. I'll worry instead about, I guess, maybe alchemy. I still haven't done too much with enchanting, though. Enchanting looks like it's gonna be perfectly fine now. Who cares? I could worry more about blocking, though it doesn't even matter that much. I guess one-handed if I had to go for something. Yeah, it sounds pretty fantastic, but I can't be a gladiator yet. I don't have perks for it. Let's go for alchemy. I don't care about that. That sounds pretty sweet. Huh? Lab skeever. Oh, yeah, sweet. I'll take that. There's the green thumb perk, which I want to get. Make sure I re-get that. There's that. The Witchmaster side effect. Oh, that sounds awesome. I want to get that. Except I have to get all this shit first. Let's get Green Thumb, though. Make sure we have that. Oh, wait, no, that's Green Thumb. Oh, that's worth twice. Oh, yeah, that's actually really good. I'll have to worry about that, then. That's for an additional 10. Where's the experiment? Oh, wow. They certainly made that a bunch cheaper. Alright, all good to go. Whatever. Enough of that shit. Anyway, that was a silly way to start out the episode. Alright, I don't think anyone would exactly mind if we say, let's try that one again, shall we? Hello, recording bar. What the fuck are you doing? Seriously? Come on. There you go. Oh, boy. Yeah, I just spent the good part of 15 minutes just reapplying perks. I didn't figure that it would actually force you to repick all your perks, but apparently selecting that did. Hopefully that does add a little bit more playability to the game, considering there's a shitload more perks. Either way, how about we have the actual start of the episode here? What's going on, guys? Welcome back for more Skyrim. In the last episode session thingy, apparently we got started on a side quest that was this big, and I had not realized, well, I mean, I sort of realized it was a DLC-sized side quest, but what I didn't realize is what the side quest was. This is not a side quest in one of the DLCs, no. This is the main DLC quest. In other words, we are playing the Wheels of LOL. No, not the Wheels of LOL, the Wheels of LOL. L-U-L-L, though I assume it is a pun off the Wheels of LOL, because of how silly it is. Either way, I don't think I really want to tackle this yet, because I went here by complete accident, but at the same time, it's like, well, you know, we could probably maneuver our butts out of here. Though, the problem with that is, of course, we have to figure out how to leave this place. Easier said than done. I mean, I'm certain if I get lucky enough, I can find my way out of here, but we certainly have to go looking around for a little bit, and hopefully that does not take us too long. Either way, they have a shitload of books that I can't touch. How to moon. Those are words. Alright. Don't care about any of this stuff. So, I added a lot of mods, as was obvious. Skill enchantments are out the butthole. I don't think you guys want to see that anymore. I'll probably have like a really cut down slot at the beginning. I still have this weird clockwork gun, which I got in the last episode, but there's even more stuff than that when you think about it. Targishian Harbicius, that's what it's called. Alright, fair enough. On top of that, I have some things I definitely want to grab from this game, and I'll make sure that I get them. Because, well, as soon as I get outdoors, I'll definitely do a nice little showcase of all the shit I added. And it'll be fantastic.
Normally, outsider, I'd throw you off the edge of LOL more. But you returned with Lavados. So I'll give you a chance.
Right. I think I remember this conversation from last episode.
Lavados' schemes, we are a bit desperate down here.
Right.
He's broken. His mind is damaged in a way I don't fully understand.
He's kind of an idiot.
Mad though he may be, he has insights that sometimes help us, sometimes harm us.
Sounds like me.
He brings things, people, and it is usually a 50% chance that it turns out bad for us.
You know, I always thought my luck was pretty good.
That's a chance I'll give. I have with me an old septum, a coin, tarnished on one side, much like your empire outside.
What?
I will flip it, and if it lands on the unsullied side, you may stay. Otherwise, you will find your home in the equations below.
Door equations? Numenor flips the coin.
Seems Sotha Sil smiles on you today, outsider. Let us hope he does the same for us.
Okay, well,
now,
that was totally
speak
random.
Speak freely, Outlander, or go away.
Nice maze?
It's a cutting sphere. A Dwemer creation. Round, yet sharp. It's my only trophy these days.
Other than your creepy-ass mask, right?
Actually brings.
Mm-hmm. So, what's the suit of armor down
here? That's a watchman. In the Clockwork City, they were our guards, but they haven't worked for a while. I've been trying to restore him, to give the place more security.
Yeah, these little, like, rabbits running around aren't really doing much. So I can help with the serious problem
I can
having.
See his logic, twisted, but he didn't tell you what was the problem, did he?
Well, I can figure it out, whatever the
That's
hell it is.
That's not his style. He's not good with words, or speaking, or handling machinery. He broke the upgate on his way out, for one thing.
The hell's an upgate?
I am better at explaining, so let me try.
That's all you're good at.
We are chronographers.
Thank you for waving that in my face. Get out of here, exposition man.
We monitor time and space and stop it from collapsing in on itself. One of the ways we do so is by overseeing the towers. This particular tower that we sit under is Snowthroat, known as the Throat of the World.
Wait, seriously?
But it is malfunctioning.
Huh?
The towers are one of the most essential mechanisms of the world. The pinpoints of the Wheels of LOL.
Oh, well, there it is.
And one by one, they are slowly...
you said
For
it!
For years, we have watched the most essential pieces of Snowthroat. But now it starts to flicker and fade, and we don't know why.
Probably because the plot demands it.
If Snowthroat has been deactivated, or is at risk of such, it is a serious threat. Not just to our order, but to Nirn as a whole.
The Nirn route? Oh, we can't
be
having that.
But we do not know
I need that for potions.
Or what causes such trouble. We do, however, suspect outside forces.
Wasn't me. We oversmelt it, dealt it, man.
because you outsiders must always prod that which should not be prod. We are fabricants. We are raised and born to love the machine, to respect it.
Well, I mean, it's on your face, you so it's sort of like hugging it. I don't really think there's a way to not love the machine.
And look around at the sad face when the machine breaks down, and we are the ones who must fix it. There is no doubt that someone above us seeks to get at Snowthroat, or is trying.
Must be Alduin.
But there are enough possible parties that we cannot leave such a thing to guesswork. We must conduct research. We must scout, as it were.
Gotcha.
That is precisely what I was thinking.
Mm.
It is, I admit, hard for us to work on the surface. With our machine parts and our glowing eyes, we certainly stand out, no? You, however, do not.
You know, apart from the dragonborn, like, whole thing, the creepy-ass follower I have with me on a regular basis, I really don't stand out that much.
There are three possible candidates in Skyrim with the ability to affect Snowthrow, unintentionally or not.
Let me take a guess.
The Greybeards.
Called it.
With their proximity. The College of Winterhold, with its lack of discipline. And the Thalmor.
The fucking Thalmor. Those are some interesting choices.
Near each of their places of residence, there will be slot points. Folds in the world mechanism that can be read for data.
Mm.
We have this. It is a device that must be installed in these slot points, from which it collects what we need.
Right.
Installing it is a complicated procedure, requiring use of an artophysical manipulator, that is, this tool.
In other words, the A button. This is a hammer. You're just only going to whack a peg into a slot with a hammer.
It is not a hammer. It is an artophysical manipulator, a very delicate device that simply looks like a hammer. But using that tool, it is not the difficult part. It is finding the slots.
Aw, son of a bitch.
The world mechanism's pieces are not able to be located by normal sight.
Aw, son of a bitch.
One must have this device. A visor that, when worn, reveals pieces of the world mechanism for one to manipulate.
That sounds pretty annoying. The magnesium visor.
Yes, for all three
so
locations.
So basically I'm playing Tron. Alright, cool.
It is what we call association triangulation.
Big words for the association of the triangle. In other words, the Illuminati.
To tell us just who
fuck,
is messing
I went and took the wrong quest tonight.
It's gonna I will be warn
great.
You, though, the pegs are a bit ornery. Hopefully, you will
not
be
great.
Able to handle yourself.
So is everything else
did,
in this goddamn
all,
game.
Here. Speaking of which,
Gizeron's talking like
now
full blast.
On. It will make things easier.
I'm always talking in full blast on the stream over there. Either way. Alright, well, time to go. Oh god, I'm over-encumbered by what? Oh, wait, how heavy was that helmet? How heavy was that helmet? Don't tell me. Don't you dare tell me. That is, pretty heavy. I mean, actually, wait, no, it weighs one. What's weighing me down so much? Wait, no. That's not weighing me down. What's weighing me down, then? Alright, now I'm lost. Why am I... Oh, this. Are you fucking kidding me? The stupid hammer bullshit's weighing 27 pounds. Alright, guess we gotta eat some food. This guy just sees me eating all this shit in front of him. He's, like, really confused. You know, man, it's just normal. Dragon bones, you're out. Alright, we out of here. Ooh, there's Furf again. Yeah, I'm out of here. Wait, did the thing just ding me? That was awesome. I heard him go bing. Either way, how on earth do we get out of here? Mr. Matt Marker, I'm gonna need your help on this one. The Librarium, maybe? I don't think we're supposed to go to the Librarium. I mean, maybe we could, maybe we couldn't. Something tells me these map markers are not exactly perfect considering that they're made by Bethesda themselves, so it's probably going to be like all over the place figuring out where the hell to go. Oh, wait, no, it actually worked out beautifully. Well, thank God. Oh, don't tell me. Wait, it is the elevator, so maybe it's just going to take me to a hub world where I can just elevator my ass out of here. Oh, look at this. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Hooray! We're out. Thank God. Dwarven Ballista, which fires a bolt that can penetrate even the thickest armor. Oh man, I want the old ladies. Stop giving me actually important shit. Strange shore discovered. Oh shit, what on earth is this? Oh, look at this. This is pretty cool. Alright, well, got him. And where am I in the glorious world of Skyrim? I'm right over there. Fantastic. So with that, guys, next comes in the next mod. You might notice that the map looks a little bit different. In fact, it even looks a bit more detailed, if you will. Yep, that's another new mod. It might not look too terribly different, but definitely go back to an older episode and look back, and you'll see that this one has a lot more, a lot more detail to it. Like, when you zoom in, you see a lot more of the mountains. Like, it's a lot more indented. It's pretty nice, actually. Very nice indeed. It's even a nice little journal, which we've always had, but, you know, it just looks nice to have. Yep, there's definitely a lot more updated, like, land to this. Like, you can see a lot more bumps, a lot more, like, effort was put into making this map look freaking gorgeous. Which is not anything on Bethesda's part, but I guess they were rushed a little bit when making it, and they just figured the map would look alright, whatever. This guy actually took his time to make a pretty sweet-looking map. I mean, look at Whiterun. You can see, like, every little detail to it. It's fantastic. But enough of that shenanigans. Let's actually get going somewhere. So, first up, Riverwood. Ain't it always the place for mods? Of course it is. Let's get going, guys. This being said, I think we're going to have a lot to do with the smithing in this episode. Just a little bit near the beginning, but hopefully it'll be panned out as we go along. So one of the first things we want to do is make sure we find ourselves a nice little barrel around Riverwood, as is always the case. And there's some salt piles, but not a whole lot of anything. Now, we need to look around this place, and we sort of need to find some barrels, because generally, mod users really like to hide shit inside these barrels around Riverwood. I guess because it's one of the starting towns? I don't know. Doesn't really make much sense to me, but they can do whatever the hell they want. Cabbage, green apples. Nope. Don't make me go look up the mod game. I'd be really upset if you make me go up look it up that mod. Don't make me do it, man. There's carrots. There's like barrels hidden everywhere in this goddamn town. PewDiePie would have a field day. Of course, that is the only thing I know about PewDiePie, is that he has a rather dislike for barrels. That's little I know about the guy. Shows what I know, right? There's a nice little log there. Of course, all these goddamn trees are really not helping me find anything. Maybe right here? Nope, sacks of flour. How about right here? Nope! Oh, this is glorious. We're really gonna have to take our time to find some of this shit, aren't we? Yep, oh well. It's always fun just spending your time looking around Riverwood, just checking every single barrel in sight. It's fantastic. It's what you guys all come to these episodes for, right? Right. At least it's all gonna be worth it the second we actually open the correct barrel. Though as of right now, I have not found Mr. Correct Barrel, which kinda bothers me. I don't even care about the salt piles anymore. I mean, I did for like 1 second, but now I don't. So, yeah, no. How about right over here? Like the very eastern edge of town. I don't know what edge of town we'll call that. We'll call that the stupermost. Yes, the stupermost edge of town. God damn my throat. I don't know what's wrong with it today, but I guess it's being annoying. I'm actually not alright, little kid. Better watch out for big guys like me. Or big girls, actually. Never mind. Alright. Really? This mod's kind of bumming me out right now. Where the fuck is it? I mean, there are some barrels up there, but don't tell me they're in those fucking barrels. Because I can't reach that. Oh, wait, yes, I can. Oop. There we go. Nope. Nope. God damn it. Where on earth is this goddamn barrel? I have all these, like, fucking lunar guidance tomes. Those are still there. Of course they are. Not even gonna touch those. Good lord. It's been a while since I summoned the moon. Oh hey, there you are, Lydia. I just realized you came along for the ride. Sorry I had to leave you behind for this stupid quest.
Still here.
Yeah, that's great.
Lead on.
Alright, Lydia, let's look around and find myself a free chest full of goodies. Which should be in Riverwood, but is apparently not. Wait, what about these chests? Nope. Motherfucker. Man, I love looking for chests. It's just my favorite. It's the best activity you could possibly do in a Skyrim game. Other than going inside your dead friend's house. Like Sven over there. I guess I technically own his house now. Turned his body into a sacrifice. Poor idiot.
Huh? What do you want?
By sure!
Skyrim has ever seen.
Huh? Thanks, Papa. God damn it. Where on earth are these barrels at? Maybe they're over on this side of town. I really do need to look this up, don't I? Otherwise, I'm just going to be running around for an entire episode looking for fucking barrels. Glorious. This is an amnesia, Ross. This is Skyrim. You can't spend an entire episode looking at barrels. It don't work like that. Alright, fine. We'll go look it up. Actually tab to something that'll work. Should I pause the recording? Yes, I should. Alrighty then. So, Riverwood's kind of back into looking like shit again. Man, it feels so barren without all that shit. Yep, main problem was, with Riverwood looking nice and pretty, it took out a bunch of barrels over here. And by taking out those barrels, yeah, we couldn't get the items. And now, it's time for some shit. Hooray! Along with an assault rifle. Don't ask. As well as some combat armor. Now, you may be saying that combat armor looks pretty broken, or looks pretty boring, I mean. But in actuality, it looks pretty fucking fantastic to me. I don't know what you're talking about. Look at me! Look how awesome I look. And it's light armor. So you know what? I think for a little bit, I'm actually going to be using this armor. It is light armor, so it actually does work with my nice little set I got going. I think it'll work out brilliantly. Along with that, even got some bullets, and it's time. It's time, guys, to finally just say fuck you to the Skyrim world. I have a fucking assault rifle now. Oh, get rid of those clockwork shots. Those are just going to break the whole game. But we do need to figure out a way to reduce our carry weight, because unfortunately we had to take off our god cleats as well as our god armor in order to wear this armor, because this armor does take both of your both my slots, which kind of sucks. In fact, that sucks a lot. Where am I gonna find some shit to drop? Drop all the fine armor. Drop the elven armor. In fact, let's just drop all my dragon shit. I don't need that. I don't need any of that anymore. It's just not important. Let's go. What's up, guard? See this gun? Ready for this? Oh, we got this. This is golden right here. I know the chicken's supposed to explode, but that was awesome. Let's see, in my defense, I'm with the Thieves Guild, so how about you look the other way?
Since you put it that way, I think we can overlook your crime for now.
Oh, this is fantastic. Fuck you, lore! Oh, yeah! Oh my god, this is fantastic. This is fantastic for all the wrong reasons. Oh, this is hilarious. Oh my god, that was so much blood. Holy shit, guard. Calm the hell down. Lydia's just knocking down all the guards because she has that ridiculous combat skills. Thanks to the new, like, oh, this guy's getting it. Don't make me kill you, dog. Oh my god. So apparently my bashing is going to be incredibly broken. By the way, yes, that was Fire Emblem music. That is another mod. Changes a lot of the fighting music with changes a lot of the fighting music to be Fire Emblem music, which is pretty sweet, I will admit. Oh my god, the exploding chickens are death. They are death incarnate. But this gun, I kind of like it a lot. It might just finally be the replacement for the gun I've been looking for. Oh my god. Yeah, I'd have to say that we have just found the gun's final replacement. It's been a long ride with our awesome gun, but I think we're pretty much happy. I look like Lana. I look a lot like Lana right now, which is hilarious. Alright. Well, Alver, I think it's finally high time I sold you my old gun. It's been a good time, Mr. Flintlock Musket, but I think it's time we finally part ways. Actually, why would I sell it? I don't need Bunny anymore. Go put it in my house. Doi. Get rid of that glass greatsword. Let's see if I can actually improve this shit, though. I guess that would be on the grindstone. Upgrade the grindstone. Oh, fuck, I didn't mean to upgrade this grindstone. Well, that's going to be annoying. Way to go, Ross. I can't even upgrade the gun. I can upgrade everything but the gun. God damn it. Can't even upgrade that to legendary? I can only upgrade it to epic? What's the difference? That's annoying. I didn't mean to upgrade that. I don't know if I can upgrade all of them. No, don't upgrade the grindstone. No, no. Device upgraded. What the? Oh my god. I have no idea how any of this works anymore. It's just become so complicated. Either way, tanning rack time. Cause it's time for eyewear. Oh yeah, we need some firewood. What kind of shit do I want? I want, not that shit. Yeah, go for, yeah, perfect. I'm gonna need to go get some firewood right now.
Looking for a new blade?
Yo, you selling firewood, man?
Blades, helmets.
Firewood, of course you aren't. Though I might have a woodcutter's axe, and if I don't, I can easily find one. Out of my way, bitch. Whoop. Alright, let's go find some firewood. Alright, do we have an axe? We have a grindstone for some reason over here. I don't remember that being there, but apparently it is. And we do not have a chopping block station unless it's over here. It is over here.
A fine day to
God
you,
damn it.
May you die with
we don't have
sword
a wood.
In.
May I not die with a sword in my hands? May I die with like my child's arm in my hands and like a bed and I get to just restfully sleep. Okay, so she has the woodcutter axe. I kind of want that. Oh, God damn it. She's gonna take that woodcutter's axe from me. Come on, take it, take it, take it, take it. Damn it!
Small village.
That doesn't really work, does it? No, I highly doubt it. Actually, isn't she the lady who gives me a shitload of free stuff?
I own the lumber mill and
no, she isn't. God damn it.
See my husband Paul.
Ugh. Come on, someone has to have it. Oh wait, it's right there. Smart one, Ross. I move your ass, bitch. I need to use that.
Years past,
yo, bitch, out my way.
For houses or furniture.
Fuck this shit, now, I'm out. Oh, God. She's getting violent. I guess I better hurry.
Used for weapons makes me sick.
Okay.
No use
bitch, you need to get the
change.
Fuck out of my way.
Too much work.
Don't make me. Don't make me. Don't. I will unrelenting force your ass until I'm allowed. Bitch, you see this gun?
Something?
See this gun? Start walking. Start fucking walking.
Hey, watch it.
Start fucking walking. Thanks. Not great enough. Let's see. Bitch. Piece of coo. Fucking. Anyway. Alright, you really need to move it. Get out of here! Oh my god, I never thought I'd have to do this, but...
Just...
There. Why did that kill her so hard? Oh my god, it took like all her health. Just from one foos. Not a foos or da, just a foos. Okay, this bitch needs... You know what? Just wait. Are you done? You're done? Thank you. This is why when you're smithing, you're allowed to kick people off the fucking forge. I don't know why it doesn't work for woodcutting, but for smithing it works. Thank you. Was that so hard, Lydia? Was that so hard? No, it wasn't.
You know what? No.
Fucking wasn't. Out my way. Alright. I do suppose it is time. Ray-Bans. Let's go. It's time to make some eyewear. Yeah, it's mostly leather stuff you can make here, but... Yep, now on this tanning rack, you can finally make some glasses. Swift and steady fingers, lockpicking, archery, and alchemy are 20% better. Identical to Croesus mask. That's actually pretty cool. I like that. Let's slap that shit right on there. Where on earth are you? There you are. Does that get rid of my, does get rid of my hat, doesn't it? No, it does not. Oh, that's awesome. Oh, look at that. That's dope. You, Lydia, you want a pair too? You'd look stupid with a pair or not.
Whatever you need.
Look at that. I look like a fucking boss now. Some nice little Ray-Ban. Look at that shit. Fantastic. There's also sunglasses you make, but I don't really need to worry about that right now. Put your dragonborn blood into the... No, don't worry about it. However, there is some other stuff we can make as we're working on this. In fact, we can make more bullets. Sweet, let's make more bullets. We're going to be needing those. Oh, wow, what the fuck? Why is my skill at the forge so shitty? Oh, no. Oh, no. When they were highlighted, they weren't actually highlighted, were they? Oh, fuck. Do you know how much time it's going to take? Oh, fuck me. This is going to take forever. Oh, no. I'm actually going to have to rebuild up my experience if I want to make new stuff. That's going to get really obnoxious. We can make sunglasses, too, by the way. For iron ingots.